Hello and welcome to this lab on data manipulation. dplyr is one of the most popular and most useful packages in the R universe, and you will learn how to use it. This package covers all aspects of data manipulation, from filtering, selection, to sorting, and many more different types of data manipulation are possible. We will work on a data frame called baby names. In the course of this lab, you will learn how to filter for specific rows of this data frame. You will learn how to sort the data and also how to select different columns of this data frame. And finally, we will use this knowledge to find out what the five most popular female baby names are and how they developed over time from 1880 to 2014. All right, let's get started. After you downloaded the file from the homepage, you can find these three files in there. So there is a final document and a template document and the R projects file. We click on the R projects file to start RStudio. And we will use the template file for working on it right now. So we will need to load some packages. One is dplyr, which we will use for learning how to manipulate the data. We will use ggplot2 for visualizing the results, and we will also use the package called babynames, which is holding the data for this tutorial. So let's just run this chunk. So you can see I have installed all the packages in advance. And now we can load the data. So you can see the auto-completion, baby names is proposed, so it's available, and if I run this line, you can see it's available. Let's take a look at this data frame with the function glimpse, and here you can see we have roughly 1.8 million observations and five different variables, and the variables are year, sex, name, the total count of these observations, n, and the relative proportion of each name. So, we now want to keep only the data from the year 2015, because that is the last one in this data frame. How do we do this? We will assign the result to a new object called most popular female, and we will feed this with baby names, which is then piped to the filter function from dplyr, and we need to filter for the year, and the year needs to be equal to 2015. So here you can see now the object was created. And we have roughly 33,000 observations, which are only having the year 2015. We also want to have only female names. So we just copy paste. We want to focus only on female names from the year 2015. So we need to adapt our assignment slightly. So we pipe this again and set an additional filter for the sex, which has to be equal to female. Let's see, that roughly brought the size to half. There might be some problem on the filter function because you have a very generic name like filter in different functions, and depending on the order of the loading of the packages, it might be problematic to call this filter function, because then it would try to use a filter function from a different package. So if you want to make absolutely sure that the filter function from dplyr is used, you can use the namespacing and put the package name in front, followed by two colons, and then it's absolutely sure that the filter function from dplyr is used. So just keep this in mind because that could result in some problems later on. We did not sort the values accordingly. So what we want to do right now is we want to take this result and sort it for the proportion in decreasing order. So for this we have the arrange function in dplyr, and if we want to have increasing order, then we could just take the column name prop. But what we want to have is the decreasing order, so we need to specify disk for descending order. So we take a look at the help. Yeah, disk stands for descending order. Very often, not all columns are needed for further analysis. And select can be applied to reduce the number of the columns. It can be done by defining the columns to be kept or by defining the columns to be excluded. I will show you how to do this. We take our code that we created before, and we are only interested in the name. So we say select and keep only the column name name. What we also want to have is, in the end, we want to analyze only the top 5 names. So let's add to our query one more statement. For this, we can use the head function because it's ordered now in decreasing order. And if we take only the first 5 observations, then we can be sure that only the first 5 names are selected. And we can check the result. Let's say as character and most popular female dollar name. And we have the 5 names: Emma, Olivia, Sophia, Ava, and Isabella. And now we want to visualize the development of these names over time. The original data frame should be filtered for these names. And the function mutate can be used to create new variables. Let's see. We will create a new object called babies2plot. And we will start with baby names. We filter again for the sex, which has to be equal to female. And with mutate, you can create new columns or you can adapt existing columns. And what we're doing right now is we are changing the proportion column, which was having a range from 0 to 1. And now we want to have it for a range of 0 to 100. So we are multiplying it by 100. But that's not all. Finally, we want to filter it. The name should be only one of the 5 names that we have discovered before. So that's done the following way. We are filtering for the column name and check if the name is in. And for this we can use the special operator percentage in percentage, and then the name is compared to the discrete observations that are found in this vector. So only these 5 names will be kept in the end. So let's run this, babies2plot, and everything else is prepared in advance. The ggplot can be created right away. And if we run this, we get the following visualization. So you can see here the proportion over the year. Actually, I have to change the year because the data frame was updated. And we are going all the way from 1880 to 2015. And we can see that certain names like Emma were very popular before, lost a lot of their popularity, but regained popularity recently. And other names are increasing very strongly in recent years. You also can check for the help. So actually, if you go to help cheat sheet, there you find different cheat sheets on the most important packages. And here you can find data transformation with dplyr. And you get some PDF document, which is describing all the functionality that is included in this nice package. And very easily you can find out how to manipulate all the different data frames, creating new columns, selecting, filtering, everything that is possible in here. All right, that's it for this lecture. Thank you very much and see you in the next one.